trichomes or epidermal appendages. There are two types of trichomes are present or epidermal appendages, the trichomes and the emergences. Trichomes are the outgrowths of the epidermal cells that is known as the epidermal hairs, pickles of rose, smilax, and ligules of grasses are emergences. The emergences are formed from both epidermal and subepidermal tissues. Number one, the trichomes. Trichome, a word of Greek origin meaning a growth of hair, are the epidermal appendages of the adipose, strong structure and function. They are developed from the epidermal cells. The cells which give rise to the trichomes are morphologically different from the ordinary epidermal cells. Trichomes are generally seen in almost all organs of plant, including the stamens of the Tetrastensia and on the seeds of the Gossypium. Either the trichomes persist throughout the life of an organ. This photograph shows the different types of the trichomes that are formed or emerged from the outer surface of the epidermis of the plants, on the leaves, the stems, as well as on the petals and Tetrastensia stamens as well. These are the special types, different types of the trichomes also present on the epidermal cells. Classification of trichomes. On the basis of morphology, trichomes have been classified into two different types. Number one, the non-glandular trichomes. A, unicellular. These are simply the elongation of epidermal cells or may be straight. For example, citrus leaf or the curved in the cochlea. Unicellular non-glandular trichomes, they bifurcate at the apex and may be Y or T-shaped. The Y or T-shaped are also present, the unicellular of the trichomes. They bifurcate at the apex and may be Y and T-shaped. In cannabis, trichomes are silicified and having the Walty protuberances. Walty protuberances means that these are the depressions or wave-like structures above the surface of the epidermis in case of the cannabis. Multicellular type of the trichomes. These may be consisting of single row called the uniseriate, or may be consisting of several rows or called the multiseriate, and branched or the unbranched. They may be of two types, the vesiculate or ramulose. The vesiculate type of the multicellular of trichomes, the terminal cell may become the rounded bladder-like. For example, in Chenopodium, they are cavitate in the appearance. The ramulose, they are multicellular complex branching structures, for example, in the plexus. These are the structures representing the multicellular type of the trichomes. This is a simple uniseriate, this is a vesiculate, this is a cavitate. Multicellular and the branched. For example, in Medania somnifera, they are present. Tufted type of the trichomes. In this type, several arms of the body diverge in various directions at right angle to the surface of the organs. For example, in Gossypium, this is the type of the tufted. Stelate, all of which are star-shaped, although variable in structures. For example, in the Cedacalvifolia, this is the star-shaped like structures in the cedar. The peltate consisting of a discoid plate of the cells, often borne on a stalk or attached directly to the roof, to the foot. For example, in Aurea cuspidata, this is an example of the peltate type of the trichome present in the Aurea. The second type is the glandular trichomes. The granular trichomes secretes sticky substances. That's why they are known as the glandular trichomes. Glandular means that the specific gland-like structures, the glands secretes the watery or the some sticky-like structures that are generally present in such type of the substances. Salt secreting trichomes, which may be a unicellular or the multicellular. The hedatode, nectar secreting trichomes, mucilage secreting trichomes, the Schedi glands, stinging hairs, digestive glands, epiglottis, the trichoblast or the piliferous cells. So these are all types of the glandular trichomes. Number one, the salt secreting trichomes. They are the unicellular, bladder-like head and very small uniseriate stalk. The stalk is accumulated in vacuole of the cell, which eventually dry off and salt remains on the surface as white powdery layer of the white powdery mass, for example, in the adsiplex. This is the salt secretory structures that remains at white powdery mass on the leaves of the adsiplex. This is multicellular. The head is multicellular and these have the basal plectin cells. These may be stalked or the sessile. The nuclei of the secreting cells are large and cytoplasm is rich in mitochondria and endoplasmic reticulum. The cytoplasm have many vesicles that may be active in the salt solution. The head of the salt gland is covered with a thick cuticle which has pores at the top of the glands. This is the specific, the multicellular type of the salt glands or the salt secreting trichomes. It has different types of the structures. This is the mesophyll epidermal cells. This is known as the basal cells, the stalk cells, the secreting cells. These secreting cells are known as the subcuticular oil storage cavities. They store special type of the substances at the glands in the form of the liquid or the salts. They, when the branch dies off, such type of the salt, glandular trichomes remains surface of the leaves and become a body consistency. Hydatode, the trichomes secrete the watery solutions containing organic and inorganic substances, for example, in grams. Janu ke andar is kisam ke glands mujud hoti hain. These trichomes consist of the multicellular and head, which is oval in shape and have the uniseriate stalk. The nectar secreting trichomes, these trichomes secrete the sugar containing solutions, and the major content is the glucose, sucrose, and the fructose. These may be present in the floral parts or on the surface of the leaves. For example, in the family Verbenaceae or the Bignoniaceae, such type of the nectar secreting trichomes are present. In flowers, they are usually situated at the base of the oval or in the family Cruciferae. They are present on the spur of the corolla as in the voilar tricarp. Mucilage secreting glands. These trichomes secrete the various types of the mucilages. The Golgi bodies secrete the mucilages in the space between the cell and the cell wall. The cuticle ruptures eventually and the mucilage reaches the surface. For example, in the Rumex dentatus, the mucilage secreting glands are present. In case of the Schedi glands, in voila, there is a multicellular central core of the cells, which is surrounded by a layer of pellicle-like elongated secreting cells. So these are known as the Schedi glands. Then the stinging cells. In urtica, these are highly specialized glandular trichomes. They are unicellular structures with a broad dilated base and narrow piriform of the pod. The epidermal cells surrounding the base of the trichome divided form a dome-shaped collar around the base. The spherical tips breaks off when the trichome is touched. The irritating cells are injected, which are generally histamine. However, this is the top, tip of the trichomes. Generally, they are injected and break off, containing the histamine chemical are present, that's injected into the objects. Next is our digestive glands. Digestive glands of insectivorous plants are another type of the glandular trichomes. Generally, you might have seen that such type of the glands are present in the insectivorous plants, maybe pitcher plants. When the insects come to the come to sucks or taking the glucose or some other substances that has produced within the pitcher plants. Inside the pitcher plant, there is such type of the glands are present. When they come over there, these insects are captured by the plants, and these glands digest all of the body parts of the insects and make them to the food.